Hey everybody, welcome back to Something Old, Something New Car Rips. Today I got something old. So if you know your baseball card history at all, you know that up until 1981, the Topps pretty much had the monopoly. I mean, they followed Bowman. Interesting is Topps bought out Bowman, so then they're just Topps. And it was a Bowman Gum Company was the first people to do it. They're actually a descendant of Playball Company. And there's Leaf. Then the early 50s, Topps got into it. Then they bought out Bowman in 56. And then in 1980, the court rules that the Topps was monopolizing baseball. Fleer sued them, and Fleer won $3 and the right to produce baseball cards. So one thing to note is in 81, they were able to put the gum in there. But after that, the courts ruled that Topps was the only one allowed to put gum in there. And so that's why Fleer went to stickers and Donruss went to puzzle pieces. So I've got the first 5 years of each of those sets out, 81, 82, 83, 84, and 85. And these are the big three. These were the only three 80 in these years. I didn't start collecting really until like 87, so I actually didn't get into any of this, and I haven't really opened any of this stuff up, except for the stuff that's coming like subscription boxes and stuff. So I figured that was kind of a cool story, kind of history of it, and figured we go through and, you know, go look at all the different years and go ahead and think rate them out. Some of these cards, hopefully like 84, 85, going to be biased a little bit because there's certain cards in there that are really nice. The Donruss, the Donruss Mattingly. It's very highly desirable in 84. I just really like the 85 Topps design. But we'll see. I'll try to keep an open mind and get into it. So some of these years have some pretty good rookies. Some of them not so good. Well, they all have some kind of rookies in there. I kind of miss having the big three like this. It made it simple back when I collected. Now you just really have Topps, and they have 50 different products, and Donruss, and they have a few different products. Topps actually still has just re-upped on their exclusive baseball license, so they'll have at least through 2025, and we'll see what happens from there. But they keep re-upping on their exclusive license. They've had the exclusive license since 2009. So let's go ahead and get into it. So we'll just go oldest to newest. I'm going to stack these all up by brand. It's got the Fleer, 84, 85. You can see that Fleer was all red. And they went to different colors. Topps cycles through their colors. See, Donruss kind of copied them with the red there. Sure as I got some cello packs. Some of the years it just didn't make sense to buy the wax packs because the price it wasn't that much more for a cello pack, so I just went ahead and got the cello pack. So one thing to note is of this early edition, it seems like everything I've read, it seems like the Fleer had the least production out of the big three, but there's all 80 cards are pretty easy to find if you're really looking for them. So I'm not sure which one we should start off with. I guess we should talk about the rookies. So 81, we got Fernando Valenzuela, Tim Raines, Kirk Gibson's in there. Kind of cool, Danny Ainge is in here, but he's not on the Topps. Harold Baines is in here, but he's not on the Donruss. So I guess I see Mookie Wilson, but we'll just go ahead and get through. So see 18 cards in 2001, and Donruss had bubble gum and cards. Like I said, this was the only year they were allowed to do that. So here's kind of things, protect your valuable vinyl albums on the back there. Vinyl album cost you what, $9.99 back then. So here's the 81. There's a big stick of gum. 81 Donruss. Billy Sample. These cards, you can hear them maybe. Just crush them coming across like that. Really rough cardstock. These are actually, well, I almost about to say pretty well centered, and then we got to that one for 81. But these things, you know, the early 80s, definitely, well, even in the 90s, they don't have the quality control they have nowadays. So there's going to be lots of cards that are awesome. But that was actually pretty well center packed. We didn't get anything in there. There's the, got a really tiny border there, different colors. Blue Jays, team name. The outfield space. Here's the back, some career highlights. And lifetime stats, and then the single season stats from 1980. And let's check out 81 Fleer. Premier Edition. 17 trading cards in here, so we already get a better value, 18. Oh, that pack opened up really easy. I don't know if that's a good sign or a bad sign. That gum looks a little better than the Donruss gum. So here we go, Jeff Reardon. Phil Garner, Golden Gloves, Doug Zacinski's, Gary Maddux. So these pretty much have a lot similar design. You got a really narrow white outside border, narrow colored border. They have their team names. Oh, there's a Yaz, Carl Yastrzemski. It's a good one. First Hall of Famer. Ken Singleton, Billy Martin as when he was the A's manager. It's a cool looking card. Checklist, Mike Davis. That's early, early in his career. Might be his rookie card, actually. Major League average, about a 211 that year. I think he stuck around for a few years, so too bad. So I like that these have the Mets symbol in here. That's nicer, and I like the way I like this setup better than this Donner. So I'm going to go with Fleer so far, and we'll check out the 81 tops. See if we can get ourselves a big reso. Here's the gum in the 81 tops. Nice big, big fat piece of gum in that one. Alvis Woods, Gary Carter. So another Hall of Famer. Larry Boa. That's good. He had a good career. Dave Winfield. There's a little tops hit to win scratch game. There's Bobby Bonds. See, Tigers future stars, Roger Weaver, Dave Steffen, and Jerry. I'm not sure how to pronounce that last name, so I won't even try. Daryl Thomas, Glenn Hoffman, Steve Carlton, record breaker. That's kind of a cool card. So, let's see. So, here's how they did their teams. Oh, we didn't check out the back of the. So, I like how they have the. Oh, we did check out the back. So, I was looking at that, see if that was a rookie card. But I like how they have the career stats there. Here's, let's see if we have one. Someone who's been around. This guy, Golden Glove. He must have been around for a while. Yep, there you go. Golden Glove. So, I love it when they have the career stats on the back of the cards. They really, a lot of them don't do that anymore, but I like seeing all the information there, especially when they have the leaders and italics or they have the little diamonds. So. And then the 81 top, so there's a little top symbol. So they do the same thing with the name, colored area. Almost the same, pretty much the same. We've got the white border, a little color border on the inside. So the only thing they really all do differently is the team name and the name itself. There's the back. The back of the Topps card is really nice, though. That's a really nice looking 40-year-old card right there, backside. Actually, we got really... All these packs are actually not too bad centering. I mean, they're not centered, but these can get really bad. I'd have to say between 81 and Fleer and 81 tops. And I'm just going to give it to 81 tops because I like... Oh, you can't see that. Sorry, it's not in the frame. I like the 81 tops because it's got the hat. And the hat wins it for me. So 81 tops wins 81. So we'll stack that up. We'll go through and we'll actually pick the best of the first half of the decade. So 81 tops there. And we'll go winners first. So we'll go to 82 tops. We'll do that first since 81 tops won the first round. So 82 tops. This is actually big. You got some big rookies in here. You got the Cal Ripken. Actually, that's the one big rookie you have, Cal Ripken. And then you have the second tier, David Geddy, Lee Smith, Dave Stewart, Terry Francona. But, you know, you're also looking for the Carl Yastrzemski, Mike Schmidt, George Brett. I didn't talk about that earlier. Ricky Henderson's, Pete Rose's, Nolan Ryan's, Ozzie Smith's. So we got 82 tops. So there's their design. They got a little fast autograph on there. So they actually did change the design there a lot from 81 to 82. There's the back of the cards. Like I said, this 80 tops always has the nicer backs, I think. Let's go through here. Ricky Kington. Rick Sutcliffe. He had a good career. There's home run leader. That's a nice card. You got Mike Schmidt, Eddie Murray, and Dwight Evans on there. I like that card. Steve Carlton again. NL strikeout record. There are checklists. St. Louis Cardinals future stars. I don't think any of those guys made it around very long. There's a Fred Lynn. The Topps has a big piece of gum again. So I guess they stuck with a big piece of gum for a while. And there is a Ellis Valentine sticker. Well, I'm not sure if that would actually stick on anything. It's not very good shape either. Gary Lavelle. Glenn Adams. Wayne Garland. There's a Jim Palmer. That's a nice card. I like that one. This actually looks pretty sharp too. It's nice when you open these old packs and everything just looks really nice. It's actually got really good centering. Oh, I like that card. This might be the best card we pull. Reggie Cleveland. Dan Meyer. Randy Bass. Barry Foote. There's a Pete Rose for the Phillies. That one's actually pretty good shape. Look at that hair. Look at his stats. I had to get him all on there. So it looks like they had not gone to the symbols. I'm pretty sure Pete Rose led the league in hits a couple of years, and I don't see anything marked on there. So by that, in 81, they hadn't yet done that. So there was our 81 Tops. Not really sure if I like the fronts that much. I like the top symbol there. There's autograph or the facsimile of is pretty cool. Like I said, I love the Tops backs though. So we'll see. Second place is Fleer. So we'll go Fleer for 82. Number one rated, number one by Baseball Hobby News. So everyone loved 81 Fleer apparently. And like I said, it was pretty nice. Just think 81 Tops a little bit better. This is actually kind of waxy. The back's there a little different color. And there's a Giant sticker. And it came with a puzzle. It's a cool sticker that actually looks like it might stick still. Maybe I'll try that out later on, put it on a box somewhere. So here we go. So it looks like for 81, they didn't really change much. Just moved over the name. You can't even tell it's a Fleer card. It doesn't say Fleer on it at all. Dave Rigetti. Ernie Witt. Dynamic duo. Is that Johnny Bench and Tom Seaver? It's a nice card. Tony Pena. Tim Foley. So I'm not a big fan of these. Well, it doesn't say Fleer on there anywhere. The backs are actually pretty nice though. They pop the color. Look at the color of the Red Sox there. That's a nice different team. Let's try a different team and see if it's just. Oh, the Braves. That's a pretty nice one too. Dave Rigetti. There's a Yankees, old Yankee symbol. So, and look at the centering on these are really nice. I mean, like I said, sometimes you get some really bad centering on some of these cards. And so far, we've seen some really nice centering. So there's 82 Fleer. Let's try 82 Donruss. So not impressed really with either of the 82 designs yet. We haven't seen any rookies. A Cal Ripken one would also be great. There's a puzzle piece, their first puzzle pieces. And there's your checklist. Lynn Jones. So I like this actually. Dennis Eckersley, that's a nice card. Well, that was a fifth year. So Hall of Famer. Goose Gossage. That's kind of a cool looking card. Rock Reigns, there we go. That's a good card. His last year was this. This is a second year card, but that's still nice. Bill Stein, Dave Frost. So for me, 82 Donruss wins this one. Let me know in the comments what you think. And let me know which way 81, or like I said, we're going to go through them all and pick the best. So I really like the 82 Donruss. So we'll start off with 83. We'll have the Donruss featuring Ty Cobb puzzle. So we're down to 15 cards a pack. We started with 18 cards. I'm not sure what the second year had. I didn't really read that. I guess I should have checked that out. They're too far away for me to grab the pack now. There's them way down there. But I really like this pack style. I like this color on this pack. So 83 Donruss. So 83's got big rookies. You got Ryan Sandberg, Wade Boggs, Tony Gwynn. You also got Willie McGee, Frank Viola, Julio Franco. Also, the Donruss and the Fleer, I didn't talk about this earlier. They kind of stuck with a 660-card set, and then Topps always had the bigger set, the 792 cards. I actually went and looked up the prices, so the Donruss and the Fleer is worth about $60, it says, and the Topps is worth $80, so see how we do. So there's our puzzle piece. Steve Garvey, good card. Good player. Rick Manning. Gary Matthews. Tim Walsh. Good start. Oh, there's a Keith Hernandez, Diamond Kings. So the Diamond Kings actually introed the year before. They weren't in the 81, but they were in 82. We didn't see one. So this is the second year of the Diamond Kings. That's a nice looking card. I like that. Started out collecting. I was a Mets fan. Keith Hernandez played for the Mets back then. So there's our 83. So you see the stats are kind of like, I don't know if you collected cards at all in the 80s. This kind of Donner stuck with this kind of format for the whole 80s. Little career highlights on the bottom. You got your stats, some personal information at the top. A lot of these early cards also have a lot of uncorrected errors or just errors in general. They're just pushing them out the door. I don't think we picked a second place for 82. Oh, definitely 82 Tops. 82. Not a fan of the 82 Fleer. Let's go ahead and do the 83 Tops. See if we can find one of those big rookie cards. Actually, one of my cards I had when I was a kid was a 1983 Opeachy. Ryan Sandberg. It's in horrible shape. I still have it, but it's all bent up and it's in terrible shape. But that was my best card I had when I was a kid. Boston Red Sox team leaders. Jim Rice is on there. Mike Caldwell. This is kind of cool. They have these little, they went to two photo design. I think 83 Tops really finally figured out they were actually in kind of a competition now and really needed to step it up a little bit. So they changed the design a lot. I like it. Oh, almost thought that was a Mets. Cliff Johnson, Ron Washington. There's a Jesse Barfield. He had a pretty good career. Glenn Hubbard. So no big stars in there. There's the backs of those. So that's actually, these are nice looking cards. 83 is actually looking pretty good. 83 Donruss and 83 Tops. I like both of those so far. Let's see how an 83 Fleer did. So 83 Fleer. Two photos on each card, so they will have two photos as well. There's the Twin City Twins. So Dave Bergman. So this is George Brett. That's a nice card. Luis Salazar. Howard Johnson. Hojo. Looks like that might be his rookie year. Probably not any value to it, but it's cool. Like I said, I started as a Mets fan, so. Gaylord Perry. With the Mariners then. He'd already got to the 307. He's had 307 wins there. Hall of Famer. Guess we'll put him on the good list. So there's our 83. A little bit harder to decide there. I guess you got to go with the 83 Tops. That really is a kind of an iconic design there. So we'll go with 83 Tops. And then Donruss. And then Fleer. Just because I'm not a big fan of that Fleer color. I'm at the backs of the Fleer cards. I guess we should look at kind of a close second place there. I'm not really sure who I'd put in second. But we'll keep 83 Tops on top. So 84 Tops, you're looking for the Don Mattingly. Really, that's the only one you're really looking for. You got Daryl Strawberry in there, Joe Carter, Andy Van Slyke. 84, the big set is the Donruss. Donruss is worth a lot more money than the other two sets. It's worth 120. Fleer was only worth 50. Tops is only worth 50. There's Diamond King errors in the Donruss. We'll get to that. They're just looking for the Don Mattingly. Don Mattingly Donruss is worth some good money. I actually don't have the Don Mattingly Donruss, so that would be nice to put in my personal collection. This is really just about seeing these cards. So if we pull a big card, that's nice. So I really like the 84 Tops. Most people really like the 84 Tops. It seems to be a fan favorite. Mark Thurman, Bill Lasky, there's a Whitey Herzog. Topps All-Star Game, there's a Don Sutton. Tim Conroy. So they stuck with two pictures on there, like the 83. They just went to a square design rather than the round design. Went to vertical team name. Everyone kind of likes that. I like the color. Everyone seems to like the color of the backs. I like the color of the backs as well. It's where they don't seem to age very well. That was the, that's not a good, I think that was the gum card. Okay, there you go. Got a team name on there. You got all stats. Let's see if we can find somebody who actually led the league in something. See if they actually started to do that yet. Don't see anything on there. So either they haven't started to do it yet or there wasn't anybody in there that led the league. So who do you say? Oh, she said it was close. Let's go ahead and go with the 83 Fleer. I mean, we can see that. So, or 84 Fleer, sorry. So 84 Fleer. Still looking for the Mattingly. Fred Lynn, Bruce Sutter. Nice saves the records on there. Harry Maddux, Moose Haas. There's an Orioles sticker and a Pirates sticker. Burt Bylevin, Cecil Cooper. It's not hitting any of the big stars or anything. Tommy John. So there's the Fleer. So I'd have to definitely put the 84 Tops over the 84 Fleer. I like the backs of the 84 Fleer though. Just it's easy for readability. And here we go, 84 Donruss. So here's a big one. Pretty smells pretty musty, so hopefully that's a good sign. This hasn't been opened at all. Let me get something good out of there. So there's your checklist. Puzzle pieces there in the front. Tom O'Malley. Dave Rigetti. I like the swoosh thimble there. Check out the back. So like I said, the backs are pretty much all throughout the 980s. There's going to be this pretty much the same, just different colored. There's a Tony Gwynn 84. That's a nice looking card. Second year card. And that is actually in pretty good shape. Not centered perfectly. Let's look at the back. Yeah, I like that card. That was probably maybe the best card we've seen so far. There's the Diamond Kings Robin Yount. It's cool. There's a Deion James rated rookie. I'm not sure what the first year of the rated rookies are. I guess I should have looked that up when I was looking up this information. Jeff Reardon. And a Randy Moffitt. So, oops, that isn't a very good design. So, 84 Donruss or 84 Tops. This is kind of... We're going to give it to 84 Donruss just for the boldness. I mean, if you look at the history, they finally, you know, went to swoops where Fleer kind of went simple. And then Tops is definitely... We'll call Donruss 1A and Tops 1B. So those are two really close ones. So Donruss ones. We're going to go with 85. So 85, we're looking for the Kirby Puckett. Roger Clemens. And then you got the lesser knowns, Eric Davis, Orr Hershiser, Brett Saberhagen, Doc Gooden. The top set here is the, really the Fleer is worth the most. It's $60. Donruss is $50. Mark McGuire's, top set is only $50. It has the, I was going to say, they have the Mark McGuire card in there as well. That's worth something. So here we go. 15 cards. It seems like there were 15 cards for a really long time. Three puzzle pieces. It's a Lou Gehrig puzzle. So here we go. 85 Donruss. This is a nice looking card. They're pushing it a little bit. Pushing the board. You know, trying different things out. So that's kind of nice. There's a Vaughn Hayes. There's the Kirby Puckett rookie. Oh, that's nice. Wow, I pulled a Kirby Puckett rookie. I'm pretty... I'm actually really excited. Kirby Puckett is one of my favorite players, so that's looks really good too. Is that how is the? Yeah, that's definitely the best card we've pulled so far. Dave Kingman, so pulled one of the rookies out of the first 5 years of there, so that's nice. Bobby Brown, so now it's gonna be really hard for me to be objective, I think, but we'll see how it goes. So the second best set was the 85. So I got this solo pack of 85 tops. Really like the 85 Topps design. Kind of move things around a little bit. Put a little more color on the front. Tim Corcoran, Terry Forster. You look, see the backs there. Dave Owen. I like the old Expos cards. Oh, there's the gum. That actually doesn't look that bad at all. It's definitely dry it out though, you can tell. Davey Johnson. He's the Mets manager. Don Baylor. Two Expos cards. Bobby Castillo, Hal McRae, and Greg Pryor. Fitzgerald and Gary Gaetti. That's a nice looking card. So right now I'd have to put 85 Donruss in the lead. Here we go, 85 Fleer. This is kind of a cool looking design too. See, win $100 savings bond. Well, that's kind of cool. 15 cards in this pack. So like I said, a lot, they just seem to stuck with 15 cards for a long time. It was just kind of like the what they did. There's the Braves. So Fleer, they went back to this 83 gray. So you got to ding them points for that, but they did put in the colored border around it, at least. So it looks a little better. Chili Davis, Terry Pendleton. There's a Wayne Gross, Alvin Davis, Mickey Rivers. That's not too bad with the colors on these ones. Some of the yellow in that doesn't. And there's the back of those cards. This guy's minor league. Spent quite a few years in the minor league there and went through a couple organizations. It's got all the stats on there, so that's always nice. I always liked all the stats. But definitely 85 Donruss wins that one. That's just a bold design. So here we go. We got 85 Donruss, 84 Donruss, 83 Topps, 82 Donruss, and 81 Topps. So no Fleer in the top five. If I had to pick, we're just picking for what it looks like. This is a visual thing, not the value of it, or and not really that we got really lucky that we actually had pretty good, well-centered cards, not a lot of bad stuff. Actually didn't think we caught any of the error cards. Like I said, the 85 Donruss is shouting out to me, but I think it's just because we pulled that Kirby Puckett. So let's go ahead and round them all up. So 85 Donruss, so black. Really like the black design. Got the Donruss symbol 85. I like the team names like that in this corner, just floating there. They're not in a box or anything like that. Backs are nice, but kind of ding points for the back because of Donruss, just because they didn't change it. Like maybe 85. This is kind of cool with this hoop there. It doesn't have the team name on the front though. Oh, it does. I'm sorry. Cards right there inside this whoop. I like the colors on the back side there. So 84, 85. Here's our 83 Topps. Top of the 83 year. This is really nice. This little portrait picture in there. I always like the Topps backs. 82 Donruss. So this is the best of a lukewarm year. So we won't even, I don't think that's going to be in the discussion. And our 81 Topps. So this is really nice, the hat. They put a little color with the white there. I mean, it's pretty much like the other ones, but they did try to differentiate also the hat, the little top symbol, and the backs. I really like when they have the little tops like that, like the 1979 Topps. Excuse me. So I'm going to have to say, though, I'm between 84 and 85 Donruss. 83 Topps. It's tough. This is a lot. 15 years I'm at, especially when you grew up, some of these cards really wanted. 84. I always wanted those cards when I was a kid. They didn't have them around. I didn't have any older collectors in my family, so I would have had to find them myself. I traded for some of the cards I did have in my collection. I'm going to have to say 85. No. 84 Donruss. That will be my number one. Number two, 85 Donruss. Number three, number four, number five. Let me know in the comments below what you think. I mean, at least we did pull one big rookie. and he's in pretty good shape, so that's a really nice card. And he's actually one of my personal favorites. So, and we did pull some Hall of Famers, some Diamond Kings, Tony Gwynn. That's a really nice card, actually. You go to my personal collection. I like Tony Gwynn as well. George Brett, that's a nice card. Rock Reigns, Eck, Tim Palmer. I really like this card. That's all I like, Jim Palmer. He was very commercialized, I guess, back before everyone, even before that was really a thing. So like I said, let me know in the comments what you think of this video. Please give me a thumbs up if you liked it. What do you think of the top set was you for the first half of the 80s when we had three big designs? I'll actually probably do the 86, 87, 88, 89, and 90. 90's getting a little bit bigger, though. This is a little simpler. 88, you got Score joining in. 89, got Bowman, Upper Deck. So we'll see how it goes. I'll try to get that all. It'd be hard to judge when you have you go from three companies to four companies to five companies to six companies. So let me know what you think. Thanks for watching. Have a great day and good luck out there.